Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about class 9th topic, chapter number 4, Ratio and Proportion, practice set 4.4. Now, before going to that, the practice set 4.4, there is one topic, that is theorem on equal ratio. What does it imply exactly? Once we have any two ratio that are equal, then we can add up their numerator and we can add up their denominator, and whatever be the ratio we will get, that should be equals to the given equal ratio.
Now look once, what does it imply exactly? Suppose we have, there are the two ratios A and B and C and D that are equal, so that the given ratio now should equals to, that means A by B is equals to C by D, that is equals to, we have sum of numerator divided by sum of denominator, that means A plus C divided by B plus D. So that now look at the question number first from practice set 4.4. Fill in the blanks of the following. We have within it first sub question, x divided by 7 is equals to y divided by 7 is equals to 3x plus 5y whole divided by dot dot dot. We have to fill in the blanks here. Now look once carefully. We have the ratio is of the form x divided by 7, that is equals to y divided by 3, and once we directly add up the numerator and denominator, so that we are getting just x plus y divided by 7 plus 3. But we will require the numerator is of the form 3x divided by 5y. So what shall we have to do? Look at the coefficient of variable x and y. We have 3 and 5 respectively. So once our ratio is of the form 3x divided by something and the 5y divided by something, and once we will use the theorem on equal ratio, then we will get 3x plus 5y as a numerator. So that first of all, try to multiply now and divide the first ratio by 3 and the second ratio by 5. Why it is so? Because we have required 3x plus 5y is in the numerator. So that now I am multiplying first ratio by 3 and divide first ratio by 3, so that 7 threes are, we have a 21, and that is equals to second ratio, now multiply divide by 5. We are getting 5y divided by 5 threes are 15. Now by theorem on equal ratio, we may have now the value for x divided by 7 is equals to y divided by 3 equals to, now let's try to compare those two ratio, so that we have to add up their numerator and denominator respectively. So that we are getting 3x plus 5y divided by 21 plus 15, we have a 36. So that I am writing the 36. So fill in the blank, we have a 36. Same for 7x minus 9y. Now we will require 7 as the multi, or we might be says the coefficient of variable x, and minus 9 be the coefficient of variable y. So let's try to consider the given ratio. X divided by 7 is equals to y divided by 3. Now first ratio should multiply divide by 7. So that 7x divided by 7, 7s are 49, is equals to second ratio, multiply and divide by minus 9. We are getting minus of 9y divided by 9, 3s are 27 with a minus sign. Now what shall we have to do? Again, by theorem on equal ratio, we can say that now x divided by 7 is equals to y divided by 3 is equals to, now look at the next two ratio, add up their numerator. So ultimately plus minus, we have a minus of 9y divided by 49 minus of 27. So after all simplifying, we will get 7x minus 9y divided by now 49 minus 27, we have a 22. So next fill in the blank, we have a 22. Now look at the second sub question. We have given now the three ratios are equal. So what shall we have to do for such a type of questions? It is just a corollary on theorem on equal ratio. That means once the three ratios are equal, we have to add up all three numerators together and all three denominators together. Whatever be the ratio we will get, that should be equals to the given equal ratio. Okay. Now look once carefully, I am writing the question first. We have the second sub question is of the form A divided by 3 is equals to b divided by 4, is equals to c divided by 7, is equals to, we have a minus 2b plus 3c divided by dot 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 dot. Now look once carefully, once we will add up directly the numerators, so that we are getting here what? A plus b plus c and divided by whatever denominator we are having. But here we will require that a minus 2b plus 3c as a numerator. So look at the coefficients of variable b as well as c. We have minus of 2 and 3 respectively. So what shall we have to do? First of all, let us try to consider the equal ratios. We have a by 3 is equals to b by 4 is equals to c by 7. Now try to multiply and divide the second ratio by minus of 2. So that we are getting minus of 2b. We have now minus of 2b divided by 2, 2, 4, 2 za, we have a 8 plus minus minus of 8. That is equals to. Now the last ratio should multiply with the and divide with the 3, because we will require the 3c over there. So that now we have 3c divided by 7, 3 are 21. Now we will require a minus 2b plus 3c. So let's try to consider among the equality of ratio, just a first ratio and the last two ratios we are having are of the form like way. That is equals to 3c divided by 21. Now again, by theorem on equal ratio, I am writing by theorem on equal ratio. Whatever ratio we are having here, that is a by 3 is equals to b by 4, that is equals to now the c divided by 7, and is equals to, now we have to add up the numerator of the ratios. We are getting a plus minus 2b plus 3c whole divided by 3 plus minus 8 plus 21. Now 21 plus 3, we are having 24, and 24 minus 8, we will get 16. So a minus 2b plus 3c divided by, we have a 16. So next fill in the blank, we have as a 16. So the given ratios are equal, and now that should be equals to, we have a minus 2b plus 3c divided by 16. Now look at the next third ratio among the given second sub question. A divided by 3 is equals to b divided by 4 is equals to, we have a c divided by 7 is equals to dot dot divided by, we have 6 minus of 8 and plus 14. Now look at the denominator carefully. We well known now 3 2s are, we have a 6, then 4 into minus of 2, we are getting minus of 8, and 7 into 2, we are getting 14. So that now the given ratio is of the form a by 3 equals to b by 4 is equals to c by 7. We have to multiply and divide the first ratio by 2. We are getting 2a divided by 3 2s are 6, that is equals to, second ratio should multiply divide by minus of 2. So that we are getting minus 2b divided by 4 2s are 8 plus minus minus 8. That is equals to, now the third ratio should multiply and divide by 2 again. We are getting 2c divided by 7 2s are 14. So that now again by theorem on equal ratio, we have the given ratios are equals to, now add up the numerator and denominator respectively. We are getting 2a plus minus minus 2b plus 2c whole divided by, now 6 plus minus minus 8 plus 14. So that our next fill in the blank is of the form 2a minus of 2b plus 2c. Now look at the question number second from practice set 4.4. 5m minus n equals to 3m plus 4n. That means we have given now the equation. That means I would like to say the linear equation in two variable. We have, there are two variables m and n. Both are having highest degree, becomes a 1 and 1. So it is known as the linear equation in two variable. Then find the values of the following expressions. We have within it the first sub question is of the form m square plus n square divided by m square minus n square.
Now such a type of examples are based on our comparando and divanando concept, keep in mind, or comparando and divanando property. So we have given the linear equation in two variable is of the form 5m minus n is equals to 3m plus 4n. Let's try to evaluate at start the value of m divided by n. Okay, so that Let's try to collect now the variable m towards LHS, and ultimately we have to collect all variables of n towards RHS, so that we are shifting 3m and minus of n. So we are getting 5n minus of 3m is equals to 4n plus n. Try to simplify it. We have now 2m equals to 4 plus 1 becomes a 5, so that 5n, so that we are getting m divided by n equals to shift 5, shift here 2 and m actually. So that m divided by n equals to, we have now 5 divided by 2. Now we will require the square, n square, n square, like that way. So let's do the squaring on both sides. We are getting now it is of the form m square is itself a square, m square and n square, that is equals to 5 square is 25, 2 square is 4. Now what shall we have to do? I am writing by using companando and divenando. What shall we get here? Look once carefully. That means we have to add up denominator in case of numerator, and is in the denominator we have to subtract denominator from numerator. We are getting 25 plus 4 divided by 25 minus 4. Now 25 plus 4 becomes 29 and 25 minus 4 becomes 821. No one common divisor, so that the value of n square plus n square divided by n square minus n square, we have 29 divided by 21. Now let us try to look ahead for the sub question second. From same question, question number 2, we have now to evaluate 3m minus of 4n divided by 3m minus of, we have 4n. Now already we have, I am writing, value of m divided by n equals to, we have 5 divided by 2. So that, look at the coefficients of variable m and n here, we have 3 and 4 respectively. So try to multiply by 3 and divide by 4. Okay, so I am writing here multiply by ultimately 3 divided by 4 on both sides to the given ratio. So that we are getting here 3m divided by 4n is equals to 5 threes are now we have 15 and 4 twos are we have 8. Now what shall we have to do? Comparando and divenando. So that I am writing by companando and divenando, we are getting here 3m plus 4n divided by 3m minus of 4n is equals to 15 plus 8 divided by 15 minus 8. Now what shall we have to do? Let us try to simplify. 15 plus 8 becomes 23 and 15 minus 8 becomes, we have a 7. So the value of 3m plus 4n divided by 3m minus of 4n is equals to 23 divided by 7. Hence here we have a question number 2nd. Now look at the question number 3 from practice set 4.4. We have it is of the form if a times y plus z is equals to b times z plus x is equals to c times x plus y, then find out a comma b comma c, no two of them are equal. That means like that way, no two of them are equal means we have given a is not equals to b, a is not equals to c. Sometimes we may have the b is not equals to c and a what next to it, c is not equal to a ultimately. Now, then we have to show that y minus z divided by a into b minus c, that is equals to z minus x divided by b into c minus a, and that is equals to x minus y divided by c into a minus b. Now, what shall we have to do? Once look at the show that statement, and if we are simplifying those denominator, so that we are getting y minus z divided by ab minus ac, I am distributing that a over the bracket, same thing, b over the bracket, we are getting z minus x divided by bc minus ab, and lastly c over the bracket, we are getting x minus y divided by ac minus bc. Now, so so that we will require the denominators as a AB minus AC, BC minus AB, and AC minus BC. So look at now the given data. We have given that A times Y plus Z, that is equals to B times Z plus X, and that is equals to, now we have C times X plus Y. What will happen now once we divide throughout by A into B into C, that means ABC, so that we are getting somewhere be the denominators are of the form BC, AC and AB combination, like that way I am writing. So that A into Y plus Z divided by, we have now A into B into C, B into Z plus X divided by A into B into C, C into X plus Y divided by A into B into C. Now look once carefully. From the first ratio, numerator denominator A getting cancelled. From the second ratio, B and B getting cancelled. C and C getting cancelled. So we might remain Y plus Z divided by BC, Z plus X divided by AC, and X plus Y divided by AB. Now look at the denominator now again carefully. We required BC minus AB, second ratio is the denominator. First ratio is the denominator, we had AB minus AC. And third ratio denominator, AC minus of BC. So that now, by theorem on equal ratio, once we have, it is of the form now, we equate AB and AC will require. So if we will equate that the last ratio with the second ratio, Z plus X divided by AC. And now addition, we have of numerator and denominator. So instead of the addition, now once we will multiply the second ratio and divide by the minus of 1, so that we are getting, look once carefully, we have to multiply and divide the second ratio by minus of 1, so that we are getting, it is of the form like this. That means now given ratio is equals to minus Z minus X, we are distributing minus 1 over the bracket and minus of AC. Now we may equate first and last ratio, so that X plus Y divided by AB is equals to, we have minus Z minus X divided by minus of AC. Okay, and all are equal ultimately, that is equals to. Now use the theorem on equal ratio. We have to add up the numerator, add up the denominator respectively, so that we are getting X plus Y plus minus minus Z plus minus minus X whole divided by AB plus minus minus of AC. Now what shall we have to do? Look at the numerator carefully. Plus X minus X getting cancelled. So we might have now Y minus Z divided by AB minus AC. This is the value for X plus Y. That means the given ratios I would like to write. Given ratio is equals to, we have this one. Let us call it as now the equation number 1. Once you will look ahead, we have ultimately here first ratio Y minus Z divided by AB minus AC, and once we are taking now the A common from the denominator, so we might write at start like way, and then we may call it as an equation number 1, so that will remain with the B minus C, called it as now equation number 1. Now no need to simplify the remaining one, we may write now similarly. What will happen once we just subtract the, now to get the BC minus AB value, so once we will subtract the third ratio from the first ratio, definitely we are getting Z minus X divided by BC minus of AB. And for the third one now, X plus Y divided by, X minus Y divided by, we have AC minus BC. So for that, we have to subtract the first ratio from the second ratio, so that definitely we are having X minus Y divided by AC minus BC. Now theorem on the equal ratio we have given as per the addition, but we can do the subtraction. As per I explained, once we will multiply and divide by minus of 1, so that we are having somewhere else the minus sign also. So we can subtract also. Okay, keep in mind. So similarly, now I am writing the second, that means the given ratio is equals to, now we have, it is of the form Z minus of X divided by B times, we have a C minus A. Call it as now the equation number 2. And the given ratio is equals to, now we have the third ratio x minus y divided by, now we have the c times a minus b. Let's call it as equation number 3. Now compare the equation 1, 2, 3. All equations are having the same LHS as a ratio. That means the given equality of ratios we are having. So that we have from equation 1, equation 2 and equation 3, we are getting now RHS are equal. That means y minus z divided by, we have a times b minus c, that is equals to z minus x divided by, we have b times c minus a, and that is equals to, we have x minus y divided by c times a minus b is of the form like this, and hence our proof. Now look at the third question from practice set 4.4. We have if x divided by 3x minus y minus z is equals to y divided by, we have 3y minus z minus x is equals to, we have a z divided by 3z minus x minus y, and we have plus y plus z is not equal to 0. Why we have given this condition, I will explain you furthermore. Look once towards the next statement we are having, then show that the value of each ratio is equals to 1. That means the given ratio equals to 1, we have to prove here like that, ratio equals to a 1. And the ratio means the given equality of ratio, x divided by y divided by z divided by equal to 2. Now look once carefully, I am writing the given ratios are of the form x divided by 3x minus y minus z is equals to y divided by 3y minus z minus x is equals to now the z divided by 3z minus x minus y. Now by theorem on equal ratios, what shall we get? Look once carefully. That means the given ratio now, x divided by something equals to y divided by something equals to z divided by whatever we are given equals to, add up the numerator, x plus y plus z divided by. What about the denominator? Add up them, 3x minus y minus z plus we have 3y minus z minus x plus we have 3z minus x minus y. What will happen? Look once carefully. Now the given ratio is equals to, we have the numerator is of the form x plus y plus z divided by. Now look once carefully about the denominator. 3x minus x we have the 2x, and 2x minus x we have the x only. Look at y, minus y plus 3y we have a 2y, and 2y minus of y we have a y. Now look at the z, minus z, minus z we have minus 2z, and minus 2z plus 3z we have a z. Now since here we have given x plus y plus z is not equal to 0, what will happen? Think over it. Once it is a 0, we will get the ratio is of the form 0 divided by 0, because x plus y plus z value now we have a 0, so the ratio is of the form 0 by 0 form. Okay, that never be possible here, so that we have given x plus y plus z is not equals to 0. Now once the numerator denominator are same, getting cancelled, so the ratio equals to 1 is to 1 means we have a 1. That means we can write our final answer now. Ratio means what? Given ratios, that is equality of ratios. X divided by 3x minus of y minus of z is equals to, we have a y divided by 3y minus z minus of x is equals to z divided by 3z minus x minus y, and now that is equals to a 1, and hence we have our proof here. Now look at the third sub-question from question number 3, practice it 4.4. We have if ax plus by divided by x plus y is equals to bx plus az divided by x plus z is equals to ay plus bz divided by y plus z. Again we have given same condition, that is x plus y plus z never be equals to 0. Then we have to show that, be concentrated on the show that statement, a plus b divided by 2. Now what shall we have to do? Again I am using by theorem on equal ratio, so that what we have now, the given ratio is equals to, we have to add up the numerator, add up the denominator, so that now we are getting ax plus by plus bx plus az plus ay plus bz all divided by now x plus y plus x plus z plus y plus z. That means we have to add up those denominator and add up those numerator. Look at the now numerator carefully. Like terms are easily added, easily subtracted as per the rule of polynomial. Same rule we are using here. Ax plus bx. Let's take that x common, we have a plus b. Plus, now by plus ay. Let's take that y common, so that will remain with the b plus a means a plus b. Addition is always commutative. Plus, next to it, az plus bz. Let's take that z common, so that we have a plus b. Whole divided by x plus x, we have 2x. Y plus y, we have 2y. And z plus z, we have 2z. Now, let's take a plus b common from the numerator and the 2 common from the denominator, so that the given ratio is equal to, now we have a plus b times x plus y plus z divided by 2 times x plus y plus z. Now, why we have given here x plus y plus z is not equal to 0? What will happen once x plus y plus z equals to 0? We will get the 0 by 0 form. That means the value of the ratio becomes 0. It is never possible. That's why we have given. Now, we can cancel out x plus y plus z from numerator to denominator. So, the given ratios are equals to now a plus b by 2. That means we can write our final answer is of the form ax plus by divided by x plus y is equals to bx plus az divided by, we have x plus z, is equals to ay plus we have the bz divided by y plus z, and now that is equals to we have a plus b divided by 2. Now look at the fourth sub question from question number 3, practice set 4.4. We have if y plus z divided by a equals to z plus x divided by b equals to, we have x plus y divided by c, then show that x divided by b plus c minus a, that is equals to y divided by c plus a minus b, that is equals to z divided by a plus b minus c. Now, let us try to assume that given ratio is equals to, suppose we have any scalar has a k, let us say, and now we have, look at the denominator towards to show that statement, we have b plus c minus of a, so that we have, this must becomes our ratio 1, this is our ratio 2, and this is our ratio 3. So we will require now b plus c minus of a, so that I am writing by theorem on equal ratio. What shall we have to do here? We have a hint. We have to add up now second and third ratio, so that we are getting denominators are of the form b plus c. So that I am writing ratio 2 plus ratio 3, and we can subtract also, so that minus of a required, so subtract the ratio 1. Okay, so that we are getting now k equals to, that means the given ratio, whatever be the equal ratio we have given, that is equals to, now we have, look at the numerator carefully, z plus x plus we have x plus y, and we have to subtract y plus z now, whole divided by b plus c minus of a. Try to simplify it, open that the bracket from numerator, we are getting now z plus x plus x becomes 2x plus y minus z divided by b plus c minus of a. So the value of k, now we can cancel out the z and minus of z, plus minus terms getting cancelled out gives us 0. So that value of k we have now 2x divided by b plus c minus of a. Call it as now the equation number 1. Look at the denominator of the second ratio from show that statement, c plus a minus b. So that c is the denominator of third ratio, a is the denominator of the first ratio, we have to add up the ratio 3 plus ratio 1, and subtract b means ratio 2. So now we have a hint here, I am writing hint. What shall we have to do? C plus a we will require, so the ratio 3 plus ratio 1, and subtract the ratio 2. So that now we are getting given ratios, that means k equals to, now we have, it is of the form, numerator of the third ratio we have x plus y, numerator of the first ratio we have y plus z, and numerator of the second ratio, we have z plus x, and that we have to subtract. Whole divided by, now we are getting c plus a minus of b. Try to simplify. Minus 2y plus 2, y plus y we have 2y. Minus x plus x getting cancelled. Then plus z minus z getting cancelled. So that after all simplifying, we are getting 2y divided by c plus a minus b. Okay, so let's call it as now the equation number 2. Now, look at the third ratio from the same question. We have a plus b minus c. That means first ratio plus second ratio, and subtract the third ratio. So that I am writing the hint. We have to do ratio 1 plus ratio 2, and we have to subtract now the ratio 3. So that we are getting here, given ratios are equals to, that means ultimately the k equals to y plus z plus, we have the numerator of the second ratio, z plus x, and now we have to subtract the numerator of the third ratio, x plus y, whole divided by, we have now a plus b minus of c. Try to open the bracket. We have now y plus z 2z plus x minus of x and minus of y whole divided by a plus b minus c. So plus y minus y getting cancelled or gives us 0. Plus x minus x getting cancelled or gives us 0. So that we have 2z divided by a plus b minus of c, called it as now the equation number 3. So look at now all three equations, from equation 1, equation 2 and equation 3. I am writing, now we have 2x divided by b plus c minus of a. Once all three equations are having same LHS, KKK, so that we can equate their RHS ultimately. So we are equating the RHS. 2y divided by, we have c plus a minus of b, and that is equals to, we have now the 2z divided by a plus b minus c. Now once we divide throughout ratio by 2, we are getting, it is of the form now, divisor and multiplier 2 getting cancelled, or 2 from numerator denominator getting cancelled. So that we have x divided by b plus c minus of a is equals to y divided by c plus a minus of b is equals to, we have z divided by a plus b minus of c, and hence we have our proof here. Now look at the fifth sub question from question number 3, practice set 4.4. We have, if 3x minus 5y divided by 5z plus 3y, that is equals to x plus 5z divided by y minus 5x, that is equals to y minus z divided by x minus z, then show that every ratio is equals to x divided by y. What shall we have to do? Once we are using here directly the theorem on equal ratio, what shall we get? Look at once the numerator only. Try to simplify. So we have to add up the numerator ultimately as per the theorem on equal ratio. So that now we have 5z and plus y minus of z. Now 3x minus of x, we have the 4x. While minus 5y, then plus y, we have the minus of 4y. And the 5z minus of z, we have the 4z. So the numerator is of the form, after all using directly the theorem on equal ratio, we have 4x minus of 4y plus 4z. Now we can't require it. Look at x divided by y, we will require. So the term of x we will require. We can't require that the y term and z term. So that we can't use directly here theorem on equal ratio. Now look once carefully. So what shall we have to do at start? Once we multiply that the last ratio by 5, what will happen? We have 5y and minus of 5z. That means numerator should multiply with the 5. So ultimately denominator should multiply with the 5. So that now we are getting minus 5y plus 5y getting cancelled, and plus 5z minus 5z getting cancelled. 3x plus x, we have now the 4x. So somewhere we have the x is in the numerator, and our target is that only. X divided by y, we have to prove every ratio. So that now here we can write here 3x minus of 5y divided by 5z plus 3y, that is equals to x plus 5z divided by y minus of 5z, that is equals to y minus z divided by x plus z, x minus of z. And now we have to multiply and divide the last ratio by 5. So that each and every ratio now equals to the new ratio. So that we are getting now 3x minus 5y divided by 5z divided by 5x plus 3y, that is equals to x plus 5z divided by y minus of 5z, and that is equals to, now distribute this 5 over the bracket and this 5 over the bracket, we are getting 5y minus of 5 times z whole divided by, we have a 5x minus of 5z. And let us say that the given ratio now is equals to, we have a k. So that now we will get k equals to, by using theorem on equal ratio. What we have now? Look once carefully. We have to add up the numerator and denominator. So that given ratios now k, and that k equals to, we are getting 3x minus 5y plus x plus 5z plus 5y minus of 5z. Ultimately, we have to add up all three numerator and now all three denominator. So that we are getting 5z plus 3y, then plus y minus of 5z and plus 5x minus of 5z. Look at the numerator and denominator carefully now. Minus 5y and plus 5y getting cancelled, plus 5z minus 5z getting cancelled, or gives us 0 ultimately. Likely 2 minus 2 is 0, minus 4 plus 4 is 0, same thing here. Okay, now look at the denominator, minus 5z plus 5z getting cancelled, and we have here, actually look at the second denominator, I made a mistake here, instead of z we have, there is a x actually, so that here is the x and here we have x. Now it will become say, correct. So that 5z and minus 5z getting cancelled, plus 5x minus 5x getting cancelled. So the value of k is 3x plus x, over numerator we have 4x, and 3y plus y, over denominator we have a 4y. Now 4, 4, same, from numerator denominator getting cancelled. So the given ratio, that means the k equals to, now we have x by y. That means we can say here, every ratio now equals to, because k becomes the equal ratios whatever we have given, and now we are getting the k value is x by y, so that we can say is at last the each ratio or the every ratio, now I am writing every ratio is equals to, we have a k, and that k equals to, we have now x by y, and hence our proof here. Now look at the fourth question from practice set 4.4. It is of the form solve. Within first sub question we are having 16x square minus 20x plus 9 whole divided by 8x square plus 12x plus 21, that is equals to 4x minus 5 divided by 2x plus 3. Now we have to work on the RHS ratio, whatever RHS ratio we are having. Here RHS ratio is of the form 4x minus of 5 divided by 2x plus 3. Now the coefficient of variable x from the numerator of RHS ratio we have a 4, and the coefficient of variable x square from LHS ratio, numerator, we have a 16. So there is a relation between 4 and 16. We have 4, 4 is 16. So now let's try to multiply the numerator of the RHS ratio by 4, so that we are getting 4, 4 is 16. But we have, among that, there is a x square in case of LHS ratio, and we have, is in the RHS ratio, there is only x. So ultimately we have to multiply by 4x. Now once we are multiplying 4x, that means we are adjusting. Okay, so that should, now to cancel out that the 4x from numerator, we have to divide by the 4x again. So that means we are multiplying and dividing by the 4x to the RHS ratio. What will happen? Once you will distribute the 4x over bracket, so that we are getting 16x square minus of 20x, and divided by, now we have 4 2s are 8, x into x, x square, 4 3s are 12, x as it is. So look at now the first two terms from the numerator and denominator of LHS ratio, that are exactly same, 16x square minus of 20x, and denominator having 8x square plus 12x. Now once we are doing the subtraction as per the theorem on equal ratio, we have there is addition, but we can do the subtraction also. So once we are doing the addition, so that the plus minus terms are getting cancelled somewhere, and it will gives us the value of x ultimately. Here we have to solve, means find the value of x ultimately. So look at, once I am writing multiply and divide RHS ratio by 4x, so that we are getting now 16x square minus of 20x plus 9 divided by 8x square plus 12x plus 21, that is equals to 4x into 4x minus 5 divided by 4x into 2x plus 3. Try to simplify the RHS ratio. That means we have to distribute this 4x and this 4x over the bracket. 4 4s are 16, x into x, x square minus 4 5s are, we have a 20, x as it is divided by 4 2s are 8, x into x as a x square, 4 3s are 12, x remains as it is. So that the given ratio 16x square minus 20x plus 9 divided by 8x square plus 12x plus 21 is equals to, we have this one. Now by theorem on equal ratio we are getting. What we will get here, look once carefully. That means let us say that the given ratio is equals to, we have a k something like that, no matter. Okay, now we have the ratio equals to, I am writing in short, 16x square minus of 20x plus 9, and we have to subtract now the numerator of the RHS ratio, x square minus of 4 divided by, we have. Now why we have to subtract, you will get the clear idea on the next step. Look once the denominator, now 8x square plus 12x plus 21 minus of 8x square plus 12x. Now let's try to open the bracket. Due to middle sign is of minus sign, further all changes from plus to minus, minus to plus. Positive 16x square, so plus minus, we have now the minus 16x square. Minus 20x, so minus minus becomes plus, so that we have positive 20x. Whole divided by, same thing over the denominator, we have 8x square plus 12x plus 21. Now minus of 8x square minus of 12x. Look at now, the given ratio is equals to, we are getting positive 16x square, negative 16x square getting cancelled, minus 20x plus 20x getting cancelled, 8x square minus 8x square getting cancelled, and same thing 12x minus of 12x getting cancelled. So that now we have 9 divided by 21, 3 3s are 9 and 3 7s are, we have a 21. So that the given ratio is equals to, now we have 3 by 7. So the given ratio is of the form 16x square minus of 20x plus 9, whole divided by, we have 8x square plus 12x plus 21, and that is equals to, we have given 4x minus 5 divided by, we have 2x plus 3, and now that this given ratio is equals to, we are getting 3 by 7. So let's for finding the value of x, what shall we have to do? Let's try to consider now the second ratio and the third ratio should be equal, because second ratio having both numerator and denominator are of the form linear equations in one variable, so it is easy to simplify. You may consider the first ratio is equals to the last ratio, but at that time you are getting that the quadratic equation in variable x over numerator as well as denominator, so it is little bit complicated to simplify. So now I am considering the second ratio must be equals to the third ratio. So consider that 4x minus of 5 divided by 2x plus 3, that is equals to a 3 divided by 7. Now use the cross ratio test, shift 7 and 2x plus 3. Now 7 is the divisor, after all shifting it will multiply to 4x minus 5, and 2x plus 3 is the divisor, after all shifting it will be multiplied to 3. Now try to distribute that 7 over the bracket and 3 over the bracket respectively. 7 4s are 28, so that 20x, 8x, 7 5s are 35, so that we have minus of, plus minus is minus, so minus of 35. 3 2s are 6x and 3 3s are 9. Now collect the variable x towards one direction and ultimately constants towards other direction, so that we are getting 28x, positive 6 becomes negative 6, and that is equals to, we have now 9 minus of 35 becomes positive 35. 28x minus of 6x, we are getting 22x, and 35 plus 9, we have a 44. So that value of x becomes, shift the 22 from LHS to RHS, it will become divisor, and value of x now 22 2s are, we have a 44, so the value of x is 2. So solve means ultimately we have to find the value of x, keep in mind. Now look at the fourth question from practice set 4.4. Within it we have the second sub question is of the form 5y square plus 40y minus 12, whole divided by, we have 5y plus 10y square minus of 4, that is equals to y plus 8 divided by 1 plus 2y. Again the same thing, look at the RHS ratio. Once we multiply the RHS ratio, now we have from the LHS numerator coefficient of y square is 5. So that we decided to multiply the RHS ratio numerator by 5. Now we have the y square be the first term from the LHS ratio numerator. So that we required the y square over RHS also. So that let's try to think. If we are multiplying with the 5y to numerator, we are getting 5y square plus 8y of 40y. So it should be equals to exactly same as the top first two terms of the given ratio on LHS numerator. So that now, so once we are multiplying the RHS ratio by 5y, so to cancel out it, ultimately we have to divide by the 5y also. So that I am writing multiply and divide RHS ratio by 5y. So that we are getting here 5y square plus 40y minus of 12 whole divided by 5y plus 10y square minus of 4 is equals to y plus 8 first divided by 1 plus 2y and is equals to now we have to multiply and divide by 5. So that we are getting y plus 8 as it is and 1 plus 2y as it is. Now we have to distribute that 5y, 5y over the bracket from numerator denominator. So that should imply 5y square plus we have a 40y minus of 12 divided by 5y plus 10y square minus of 4 equals to now required ratio whatever be the simplified one 5 1s are 5 y into y square plus 5 8s are 40 y as it is 5 1s are 5 y as it is 5 2s are 10 y into y square. Now once we are doing the subtraction of numerator then we are getting somewhere with a constant number like 12 divided by 4 means the 3. How? Look once carefully. So by theorem on equal ratio we are using here again. So the given ratios are equals to now subtract the numerator 5y square plus 40y minus of 12 minus of 5y square plus 40y whole divided by we are having 5y plus 10y square minus of 4 and minus of 5y plus 10y square. Now let's try to open the bracket so that we are getting 5y square plus 40y minus of 12 plus minus minus 5y square plus minus minus 40y whole divided by 5y plus 10y square minus of 4 plus minus minus 5y plus minus minus 10y square. So the given ratio equals to we have this one. Now look at the numerator carefully. Positive 5y square, negative 5y square getting cancelled. Plus 40y minus 40y getting cancelled or gives us 0. Look at the denominator 5y minus 5y. 10y square minus 10y square getting cancelled. So the ratio is equals to now we have minus 12 divided by minus 4. Now the remainder from numerator denominator. Minus minus plus 4 3s are we have a 12. So the given ratio is equals to 3 is to 1. Or we might be saying the 3. Now we have given the ratio is of the form 5y square plus 40y minus of 12 divided by 5y plus 10y square minus of 4 and that is equals to we have y plus 8 divided by 1 plus 2y and that is equals to now we have a 3 because given ratios are equals to now a 3. Now to solve the given ratio or equality of ratio, what shall we have to do? Ultimately, we have to find the value of variable. That means here we have the variable is y. So how to find here value of variable y? So for that, let's try to consider or equate that second and third ratio. Because look at the second ratio, numerator and denominator, both are the linear equations in one variable. So it is little bit easy to simplify. Once you are considering, no doubt, first ratio is equal to the last ratio. But at that time you are getting the quadratic equation over numerator and denominator. It is little bit time consuming or the complicated to simplify. So now I am considering the second ratio must be equal to that of third ratio. So consider that y plus 8 divided by 1 plus 2y that is equal to 3. Try to shift the denominator from LHS to RHS so that y plus 8 equals to we have denominator becomes numerator or divisor becomes multiplier to whom? To 3. 1 plus 2. Try to distribute now these 3 over the bracket so that we are getting y plus 8 equals to we have a 3 1s are 3 plus 3 2's are we have a 6, so that we are getting 6y. Now, to find the value of variable y, what shall we have to do? Try to shift the y as well as 3, so that 8 minus 3 equals to we have a 6y minus y. Now, 6y minus y, we have the 5y, and 8 minus 3 becomes a 5. Shift that 5 to evaluate the value of y. We have a 5 divided by 5 means a 1. So, the y value we have a 1. Hence, here we have our practice at 4.4. Thank you.